Hello students, I am Mr.G.B.Agalave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this third session, we will see infinitely long fin. So the learning outcome is, at the end of this session, students will be able to derive equation for infinitely long fin. General heat conduction equation for rectangular fin. Now there are three cases of fins. First one is infinitely long fin. So case first, infinitely long fin. Suppose this is the base of the fin. We are going to use the same notations. So this is the fin, the base temperature of the fin is T naught, the surrounding fluid temperature is T infinity. The length of fin is infinity. As we know, the general heat conduction equation, that is theta is equal to C1 e raised to mx plus C2 e raised to minus mx. In the last session, we have derived this general heat conduction equation. Now, for infinitely long fin, the boundary conditions, first boundary condition is at x is equal to 0, at x is equal to 0, theta is equal to theta naught. And second boundary condition, at x is equal to infinity. Now, why this theta is equal to 0? For infinite long fin, the end temperature would become equal to surrounding temperature. So, T infinity minus T infinity will become 0. Now, using first boundary condition, so we require to substitute these values in the general heat conduction equation. At x is equal to 0, theta is equal to theta 0. So, this becomes theta 0 is equal to C1 e raised to 0 plus C2 e raised to 0. So, this becomes theta 0 is equal to C1 plus C2. Now, we will try to find the constant values. Using second boundary condition, at x is equal to infinity, theta becomes 0. So, I can write 0 is equal to C1 e raised to m infinity plus C2 e raised to minus m infinity. This is 0. This is 0. Now, here this can't become 0. So, C1 will become 0. C1 is a constant. If I substitute now C1 is equal to 0 in the equation second, I will get theta naught is equal to C2. Now, these are the equations of constant C1 and C2. Substituting these in equation number 1. If I substitute these constants in the first equation, then theta will become equal to C2 is theta naught e raised to minus mx. I can take the ratio of theta, that is theta by theta naught is equal to e raised to minus mx, which is nothing but t minus T infinity, this theta is nothing but T minus T infinity divided by theta naught is a T naught minus T infinity. This becomes temperature distribution equation. This is known as temperature distribution equation. Means what? At any known length, at any known length of the x, at any x, suppose x1, x2, etc., we can find the unknown temperature at that location, as T naught, T infinity are easily measurable. Now, after this, for the same case, we will try to derive the rate of heat transfer. Rate of heat transfer. Here, we can use the Fourier's law of heat conduction, that is Q is equal to minus K A d theta by dx. As we know, in the fin, heat enters from the base, that's why this temperature gradient should be at x is equal to 0. Now here, as we derived equation third, so I can differentiate equation third with respect to dx at x is equal to 0. So, this becomes equal to theta naught minus m e raised to 0 is 1. So, this becomes equal to minus m theta naught. I can substitute now the equation for d theta by dx at x is equal to 0 in this equation. So, Q will be equal to minus K A minus m theta naught minus minus plus. So, this is K A into m into theta naught. Now, please recall the m equation. As we know, m is nothing but square root of h p by k a into theta naught. This I can write as 2 times k a into k a into square root of h p by k a into theta naught. So, the one will get cancelled and this Q will become equal to, I can rearrange and can write H P K into A into theta naught, which is also equal to H P K A theta naught is, so what is theta naught? T naught minus T infinity. So, this becomes rate of heat transfer for infinitely long fin. Here, I will introduce one new term known as efficiency of fin, which is equal to rate of heat transfer from the fin to the maximum possible heat transfer. Now, this Q max is nothing but H A theta naught. Why? So, maximum possible heat transfer would be in the case in which the fin temperature would be at T naught. So the rate of heat transfer would be by means of the convection from the fin surface to the surrounding. That's why this becomes Q convection becomes H A theta naught. So this is H A theta naught, and this Q is as it is derived in this equation. So I can write now the rate of heat transfer from actual Q to the Q max. So this area is nothing but perimeter into length PL theta naught. So this will be the fin efficiency. We can substitute this equation here and we can find the efficiency of fin. For further reference, you can have fundamentals of heat transfer, heat and mass transfer by Incorpora David. Thank you.